Mubina Kapasi caught up with PV Subramaniam of Subramani.com, who said that a bout of redemptions may be due to job losses. However, he strictly advises all against treating mutual funds as an asset that should be used to book profits for when the market rallies. Listen into an excerpt of this conversation.
Yeah, all these things are happening. One is, when a 53-year-old pilot loses his job, he's not sure whether he'll get it back. So, right, so maybe his retirement has already happened at 53 instead of 60. So, some withdrawal will happen for him to meet his household expenses, and his ability to invest money is also reduced because he cannot put in money because he doesn't have a salary. Now, that is true for very many people.
What would be the pecking order according to you, Mr. Subramaniam, if I actually have to go in and, you know, sort of liquidate my savings, assets, you mentioned Provident Fund, you know, mutual funds, of course, we are seeing that phenomena. But of all my assets, I mean, is there a pecking order? Because if I look at Provident Fund, I think that, look, this is, you know, this is my nest egg. And then if I'm looking at mutual funds, I feel that, oh, but I have to also invest in the long term. So How should one essentially sort of starve off this period of lull where, you know, I'm jobless, but I still, of course, need to feed myself and my family?
So the most difficult thing to ever liquidate would be real estate, because you'll not be able to sell real estate during such a situation. So selling real estate is out. If you have old endowment policies of LIC, of even of a private sector companies, which are now 20 years old, that would be the best, because there you're anyway going to get only 6 or 7% return at best. So best is to redeem that or take a loan against that, that you may be able to get at 8 or 9%. That would be the pecking order. But what happens is the easiest to withdraw is the mutual fund. At the click of a button, all those things which were told to people, इसमें कभी भी आ सकते हो, कभी भी जा सकते हो, no entry load, no exit load. So people are listening to all that and now they are implementing. They're saying, oh, I need money here. At a click of a button, I can get it from a mutual fund. The easiest money to redeem is, of course, the mutual fund. So people are redeeming more from mutual fund than from insurance company. Provident fund, perhaps those people have already redeemed their mutual fund and therefore they're withdrawing from their provident fund. So these would be the reason. There's nothing. If you have equity shares, if your share is largely, people sell whatever is doing well. So if they bought a share at 10 rupees, which is now at 20 rupees, they would sell that. But they bought another share at 10 rupees, which is at 8 rupees, they will not sell that. So like what Peter Lynch says, watering the weeds and plucking the flowers, people will do. They will sell their best shares and they will keep their badly performing shares.
Do you think that a mutual fund is the instrument devised for the kind of activity that we are witnessing? Let's assume that, you know, somebody does have their job and they don't really need the money. But many a times people are also looking at it like we had Mr. Sunil Subramaniam, the MD of Sundaram Mutual Fund, saying that what we are observing is that many people are looking at the market and thinking, let me take some money off. But Mr. Subramaniam explained why, you know, a mutual fund is not the correct instrument, you know, to do something like this, where you can just take some money off because the market is up.
Yeah, it's very expensive because if you get out within 1 year, you pay an exit load. And you pay 20% income tax if you make profit. If you're making losses, there's no point in getting out. However, like I said, people will do this watering the weeds and plucking the flowers. So they've invested in a mid-cap, large-cap and a small-cap fund. They find that they're making money in the large-cap fund. They will remove the large-cap money and they will keep the small-cap money. And wherever they're making profits, some of the profits they will book and they will say, okay, mera itna loss kam ho gaya. Let us say they're 10 rupees, they've invested, their NAV has become 20 rupees, and from 20 it becomes 19, they will say, oh, I've lost 1 rupee, so next day they will go and redeem. So people redeem because they are making money. So any fund which is making money for them and they are in the plus, they will very likely redeem and say, I will wait. And there are other people who redeem and say, you know what I did, Subra, I removed all the money from my equity funds and repaid my housing loan. Now this is such a rotten thing to do. But yes, people do this, especially when they're uncertain about their jobs.
You know, Mr. Subramaniam, why do you think that that's not the best thing to do when someone sort of redeems all their mutual funds to pay off their loans? I mean, I'm sure this is a thought that may have, you know, come to a lot of people's minds. So why are you against it?
No, I'm not against it. I'm saying if your job is there, you have a good job, it is paying you well. Based on that, you took a 20-year loan. Based on that, you also said, I will do an SIP of so and so.
Yeah.
And therefore, I will make sure that my retirement plan gets filled up. Now, suddenly you change because you see the ticker moving, right? So don't get moved by the ticker. See what you want over the long run. Mubina, what I say today can look very smart. What I'm telling you is if you had invested, if you had removed money in the month of January and you had repaid your loan, you would look very smart today because the market has come down. However, if you do it now, 6 months later, you could look like a complete idiot if the market recovers. Because if you see interest rates now, this is perhaps the best time to be borrowing because the interest rate for a housing loan is at 7.30. When have you seen it? I'm sure you have not seen it. You must have been in school when it happened at 7.30. It was real long back. So this is not the time to be repaying your home loan. This is the time to be staying steady with your asset allocation. If anything, sit with your financial advisor and decide what to do. Don't react in panic.